Okay? But anyways, I digress. This is back within the book of Isaiah, the 24th chapter, and the 6th verse. It says, therefore hath the curse devoured the earth, and they that dwell therein are desolate. Right? Therefore the inhabitants of the earth are burnt, and few men left. Okay? So when this thing pops off, there's going to be a few people, there's going to be a few men left. Okay? And as pertaining to the righteous, as pertaining to the Israelites, there's going to be even fewer, because the Lord's going to have it to where there's going to be what's known as the ethnic cleansing. Okay? Here it is, Jake is getting up into Esau's way of thinking, the ways of the heathen thinking. Okay, the scripture talks about how the ways of the heathen seduces Israel. Well, they're getting all up into the ways of the heathen, getting up into Buddha, getting up into Islam, getting up into Christianity. Those are the ways of the heathens. So they've been seduced by those things, okay? All right, and they, you know, when we came out there, we gave them reproval of all that. They didn't turn into reproval of the Lord. Well, guess what? The Lord said, look, boom, I'm going to give you the hammer right there, man. Okay, you're going to be destroyed. Okay, so you're going to have it to where there's only going to be a small remnant that's going to be praising Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. And those are the men that's going to be delivered, man. And they're going to do what? They're going to reestablish themselves upon the face of the earth. And through their seed, you're going to have it to where the whole nation is going to be rebuilt again. Okay? So you got it to where Jakes are all over the place doing all kind of wickedness. Well, once they're destroyed and they come back, they're going to be in their right mind now, man. Okay? They ain't going to be worshiping Buddha. They ain't going to be doing all kind of wickedness and all of that. They're going to be in their right state of mind, man. Okay? Isaiah 24 and 7, it says, the new wine mourneth, the vine languisheth, and the merry-hearted sigh. So you got people right now, they're in that state of laughing, being merry, okay? Right, being given into marriage, okay, which is we go across the road right now. Okay, they're in that state and that mindset, but ultimately that whole thing is gonna be turned against his own head, man. Okay, that's gonna be overturned, and what's gonna be left is sighing, crying, okay, languish, mourning, okay, because the Lord's got a great heavy judgment that's gonna come upon this place. Ultimately, it goes back onto the thinker, and that's a good scripture to bring out later. The book of Zechariah, the 14th chapter on the 12th verse. Because here it is, you got all of this judgment playing out. Okay, here it is gonna happen to where all of these people gonna be destroyed. But people don't understand why that reason is. Why is the Most High having it to where America is going to war against Russia? Why is them things happening? And it goes back onto the simple fact that the Most High has had it to where Esau had Jacob in captivity for a certain amount of time. And as a result of that, judgment's gonna come upon Esau. Okay, it's the balancing the scales. The scripture talks about how it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense them that trouble you. In other words, when you avenge yourself in righteousness, that's a righteous act. In other words, a tooth for a tooth, eye for an eye, man. Okay, when you go into our scripture or into the doctrine of the scriptures, it talks about that. Here it is, if a man stole your cattle, hey, there's going to be a certain amount of retribution that's going to happen as a result of that. But the old things are in balance. You don't go out there kill somebody because he stole an apple. That's where Esau comes into play, because Esau will bring about that kind of judgment, man. And that's why he's going to be destroyed. Okay, so back within the book of Isaiah, the 24th chapter right here. And this is the, back. This is the 6th verse. Okay, so Isaiah 24 and 6. It says, therefore after the curse devoured the earth, and they that dwell therein are desolate, and therefore the inhabitants of the earth are burnt, and few men left. Okay, and then let's go to the 10th verse. Okay, the city of confusion is broken down. Okay, and when you break down the word Babylon, okay, it goes into the what? It goes into Babel, which means confusion, and Lon, which goes on to the word land, okay? The land of confusion, the city of confusion. The scripture is saying that what? That city of confusion is broken, okay? Is destroyed, okay? The spearhead of all of that confusion that's being perpetuated upon the face of the earth, that's been destroyed, okay? The bringer of the demise of these empire, these different nations, okay? And their rulership, that's destroyed. The person that's going out there raped, robbed and murdered, okay, that city is destroyed, okay? But here it is, you're gonna have a power void, okay? And that's where the Chinese think they're gonna come in and do their thing, okay? They think that when this power void is created and America is destroyed, they're gonna be a superpower along with Russia. That's why they're trying to set up their so-called joint currency together. But see, nobody's thinking about Israel. Nobody's thinking about the Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans. They ain't thinking about the Israelites. They're thinking about, look, we're going to be the next ones. And that's where the Most High is going to raise up his men, starting first and foremost with the elders of GMS coming out here teaching his word. Okay? having it to where the prophecy of being fulfilled in then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the faces of afflicted him. Really, all of these nations are afflicted us. So that's why we're out there cursing them out, man. Telling you, look, you're gonna be destroyed, man. The men are gonna be our slaves, the women are gonna be our bed wenches, man, our bed warmers. Okay? That's what's gonna be established upon the earth, man. Okay? So when that power of word is created as a result of the sea of confusion being destroyed, well, the Most High is going to establish some new power upon the face of the earth, which is really the old power, but now it's going to be even more powerful, man. Okay? When the Most High has it to where the power of word is filled, it's going to fill that void with the people, the Israelites, okay? And now they're going to have complete and utter dominion, like Adam had complete and utter dominion over the earth. The Lord's going to have it to where that's what they're going to have now. Okay? So let's go back within the book of Isaiah, the 24th chapter, and the 9th verse. So the 10th verse I was at. So it says, the sea of confusion is broken, okay? It's broken down, and every house is shut up, and no man may come in. So what's that dealing with? That's dealing with you got these shops, okay? People go out there to Macy's, people go out there into Primark, people go out there into what? Into Marks and Spencers, whatever, okay? And they do their thing, they buy whatever they gotta get, okay? Get some food, get some clothes, okay? These big stores, your stores like Walmart, okay? So everybody's doing that, they're on that game, okay? They're buying their resources and that. But here's the thing, when this thing pops off, you ain't gonna have it to where you got trucks coming in from the shipyards, okay? You ain't gonna have it to where you got trades happening between India is making all kind of clothes, and they're gonna bring those clothes out there into America or into England, okay? When this whole thing pops off, you're gonna have a mass movement of resources back and forth. So you're gonna have it to where Tesla's gonna be open with your food. Where is Tesco gonna get their food from? It ain't like Britain's producing much food. It ain't like America's producing much food. Okay, that's what you know as consumerist states, and as a result of being consumerist states, well, guess what? When that movement of goods stops, the consumer is gonna stop too, man. Okay, that's why the scripture talks about when the missiles gonna drop. Well, guess what? There's gonna be a certain amount of people left, and they're gonna be worse off because they're gonna be dying by way of hunger, man. Okay, they're gonna die by way of being thirsty. Ain't gonna have no. Hey, what's up, man? Yeah? You believe in the scriptures? You believe in God? You believe in the Bible?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, so what does the scripture talk about?
I don't go on to in depth, man.
Alright, okay. Oh, okay, let's go surface, okay? Don't go 2D, we go 1D, okay? So, the scriptures talk about salvation, right? Okay, so what does salvation mean? What's the essence of that? What does that mean
salvation.
To you? Salvation. Being saved. You got a lot of people talking about they're saved.
All I think is you can be the best you can be.
Right, yeah. Okay. Okay.
Trevor Cairns, everybody. And,
now if you had an all-out world war,
yeah,
and you were saved from that, wouldn't that be salvation?
Yeah, I suppose.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when this thing is popping off between America and Russia, how can anybody be saved already?
Exactly, yeah. Difficult, isn't it? Yeah.
So you can't be saved?
No.
Okay. So when you go into the scriptures talk about a World War III. You're going to have World War I, which was happening.
Yeah, about this. Yeah, yeah.
World War II, yeah. And then World War III was going to be between America and Russia.
Right.
Right? Now, you know those things are playing out right now. We can see that.
There's a lot of things underhand as well.
Yep. Syria, Iran, yeah, Israel. Yeah. Those are all underhand things that all lead up to World War III. Okay?
Yeah, all this whole frightening stuff. Well,
now, the simple question comes to what? Who's going to be saved when that World War III comes about?
I mean, you, brother.
Right, I could hope so.
Yeah.
I could hope so. But ultimately, it goes back onto to the scriptures, where the scriptures talk about the Israelites going to be saved out of it. Right?
Yes.
The question is, who are the Israelites? Who are the Israelites? I put that question to you.
The Israelites, I would have thought, was the disciples that followed Jesus and...
Right. So...
people that...
Right, okay. So you got... everybody comes from 18 nations within the Bible. You got the Edomites.
You know a lot about your stuff. Yeah, you know.
I got good teachers.
Good man. Yeah,
I got good teachers.
Yeah.
Right? You got 18 nations, biblical nations. I'm not talking about African. English. I'm talking about biblical nations.
Biblical nations. Yeah.
Israel is a biblical nation.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
Israeli is not a biblical nation.
Okay.
So you got it to where you got the Israelites.
Yeah.
Okay. The Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans. Okay. But the curse was this: that when those Israelites was gonna go into captivity by way of slaves, since Deuteronomy 28th chapter on the 68th verse, the 64th verse says they was gonna be dispersed across the whole earth.
Right.
So when you have it to where you had the Vietnam War, and you had it to where the American soldiers were up into there, and they saw them pretty Vietnamese women. What were they doing with them pretty Vietnamese women?
Well,
they were popping them, man.
Yeah.
They was getting all up into it.
Yeah.
But does that mean that those children are Vietnamese?
It says.
Yeah.
No. I know what you're saying, man. Yeah.
Those are the descendants of what? Of the soldiers that.
Yeah.
But those soldiers were Israelites. Does that make sense?
Sure. Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go a step further. Let's build up on the idea. The man Tom Jones sings like a black guy, but looks like a white guy.
Yeah.
That's because he's an Israelite.
Oh, okay. All right.
Right. Because his lineage goes back onto the Israelites. Okay. So now you're seeing, starting to see the bigger picture. It's not just a thing of black or white.
No.
It's about the your nationality, where your seed comes from.
Yeah, man. Yeah,
right. So if your seed, if you're a seed of which I think you might be an Israelite, man. Where are you from? Ireland? Where's your parents from?
I'm always York.
No, but where are your parents? Where's your parents from?
They're from England, but they're supposed to be Irish.
Right. Okay. Well, the Irish were known as what? As the niggers of Europe.
Right. Yeah.
They were known as the niggers of Europe because a lot of the Irish are the descendants of Israelites. Okay, because prior to the 1600s, when Esau set up what was known as what? As the Renaissance of what? You know the word Renaissance means rebirth.
Rebirth, yeah.
Right, the rebirth of the Roman Empire.
Right.
Okay, back where Esau, okay, by way of complexion, by way of simplicity, the so-called white people were back in rulership, the rebirth of that, hence you had a Renaissance period, hence Renaissance art. So all of the black images that were there, they got whitewashed.
Alright, yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
But in Europe prior to the 1600s, you had empires of so-called black people here. They don't tell you about it within school. Yeah. They don't tell you that King Henry VIII was a so-called black person.
Yeah, no.
They don't tell you Shakespeare was probably a lot more like Al Shapton.
Yeah, I believe it. I believe it.
Right? Like I said, with my first example, When you have it where they are missed.
They all cover things up for their own means, you see, don't they, along the way?
Oh, you gotta cover up. But in order to cover up, you gotta know the truth. But the simple truth is that what? That the people of color you have out there within America, the vast majority of them are the Israelites. But the people out there also that are in with Ireland right now, because they were popping them white women, a lot of the lineage goes back onto what? Israelite. Although they may look like white people. So you could be an Israelite. I don't know.
Yeah, we don't know. Yeah,
okay, but when we were talking about World War III, who's going to be saved out of that?
Yeah.
It's only going to be the Israelites, man.
Yeah.
So you better hope. Anyways, you have a good day, man.
Yeah,
okay, man.
Hey.
Likewise, man. You take care, man. Okay, so this is back within the book of Isaiah, the 24th chapter. And go back to the 10th verse. So it says, the sea of confusion is broken down. Okay, every house is shut up that no man may come in. Okay, so when you're gonna have it to where you ain't gonna have a mass movement of resources like you have right now. Okay, right, goods being transported from Germany, goods being transported from India, goods being transported from where, all over the place. Okay, yeah, you ain't gonna even have the movement of oil. Like, save that the Lee banking family is gonna have a certain amount of oil that they're gonna have to themselves. But you ain't gonna have a vast movement of oil and resources, so you ain't gonna have a vast movement of food and water, man. Okay, everything's gonna be stacked, so them houses, them shops, they're gonna be boarded up, man. Ain't nobody gonna be dealing like that, how they're dealing right now. You're gonna to where people are happy, they got food within their bed, they got water in their stomachs. Okay, they're good. You're gonna have that no more, okay? So it says that, the house is shut up that no man may come in, right? There is crying of wine in the street. All joy is darkening, okay, and mirth the mouth and the land is gone. So when you have a resource is not being moved because this thing's popped off, okay, all right, you had it to where the World War III is being played out, well, guess what? You're going to have people partying out there. What are they going to do? What are they going to eat? What are they going to be partying about, right? Okay? It's going to be vast amounts of death going out there, okay? So that's pretty much it. I can go back onto the book of Jeremiah, the 51st chapter, and we can carry on with that. So back within the book of Jeremiah, the 51st chapter, and this is the third verse. It says, against him that bendeth the bow, let the archer bend his bow, and against him that lifted up his brigadine and spear, ye not her men, right, and destroy her utterly in all of her hosts. And that's where I gotta go to the book of Isaiah, the 13th chapter, because the book of Isaiah, the 13th chapter, goes to show you that what hell of a lot of people is gonna be in a weak state of mind, man. Okay, because we got all of this death going up about the place. You got a lot of people getting burnt up. You got a lot of people having buildings fall upon them place. The scripture talks about they're gonna be earthquakes too, man. The scripture doesn't talk about just a World War III going to play out, and that's just it. World War III being played out. You got biological weaponry being let loose, okay? You got it to where you got earthquakes popping off all over the place, man. Okay, because a lot of those ICBM nuclear missiles going to trigger off what? They're going to trigger off a lot of earthquakes all over the place, okay? Of which we know a lot of those earthquakes come by way of what? Of the harp system that Esau's implementing. Okay, and that's why he thinks in his mind he's the most high, because he can have it to where earthquake pops up all over the place, man. He's got the technology, okay? He set up the technology by way of the harp system, so he thinks in his mind that he is the most high. But see, the most high is going to destroy him in his own enterprise and trying to establish himself as what? As the so-called new power, as a superpower upon the face of the earth. He's going to destroy him in his own enterprise in trying to obtain the birthright by way of the birthright that he was given, which was the sword. Okay, and he's going to really establish the birthright of Jacob, and everybody's going to see. And then the name of the Most High is going to be the name of Israel is going to be appraised upon the face of the earth, man. They're going to know in that day, man. Dudes is going to know, man. Okay, they're going to be okay. There goes royalty right there, man. You better bow your head down. That's what they're going to be teaching their kids, man. Because they're going to know, look, this is the masters, the true masters. You got into where the elite banking families right now, they're dealing in the background. Okay, so we're gonna have a council, okay? We got a problem right now. We got it to where these Jakes are pushing out this truth out there, okay? And it's becoming a problem, okay? Let's have it to where them guys out there in IUIC start pushing more of an agenda, all right, that's more in tune with the Black Lives Matter thing, okay? And that's gonna be what? That's gonna lead to what? Their minds, because the Most High ain't dealing with no Black Lives Matter. The Most High is dealing with Israelites. But what about the Israelites that are dispersed amidst the Edomites? What about the Israelites that are dispersed amidst the Moabites? Okay, now that's the thing that the ISUPK don't go into, man. They're just a black movement, and the Most High ain't dealing with a black movement. In fact, the word black means darkness, emptiness, void of knowledge. And them dudes are completely void of understanding of the scriptures, man. Because if they understood the scriptures, they'll understand the God. The dudes out there within Nigeria, they got hella flavor, okay? They got hella salt, okay? Them dudes are Jakes, man. Okay, them dudes are descendants of Israelites, and they'll understand if they went into the history that, okay, you had it to where the slaves came over into America. Where did they come from? Oh, they came from the west of Africa, or which parts? Or they came from places like Ghana, Nigeria. Oh, well, that means that the Nigerians are Israelites too, man. Okay, so them guys are devoid of understanding. Okay, but that goes to show you that what? There was going to be a certain group of the understanding, a certain group of people with the knowledge. There's going to be other groups that just didn't have it, man. Didn't have the soul. Okay, in other words, many was going to be called, but there was going to be a few that were actually chosen to do this work in its purity and in its entirety, man. In other words, there's going to be a certain group of people that was going to have the 100% truth, man. And that's the simple fact of the marriage. That's just so blatant and obvious in the In the works that people be pushing in. So Esau's got it right now that IUIC is pushing a doctrine that's more in tune with worldly philosophy. ISUPK is pushing forth a doctrine that's more in tune with the worldly philosophy. But at the end of the day, guess what? The Most High is going to have it to where this word is going to come out when it's purity, okay? And ultimately Esau's going to be destroyed, man, okay? So let's go back onto the book of Isaiah, the 51st chapter. And I was in the... No, I wanted the Isaiah. I was in Isaiah the 13th chapter. I was trying to get Isaiah the 13th chapter because the scripture is talking about here, and I'll go straight to the point on this one. The scripture is talking about how that what all of their so-called men of war, okay, their so-called GIs, okay, government issue, okay, their so-called military men, generals, and all of that, okay. The Most High is saying, look, the eye of them Russians ain't gonna spare. And the Russians are a very hard, austere type of group of people, man. Okay, when they see that, look, this is the enemy. We gotta jump on the enemy to establish themselves. They're not gonna hold nothing back, man. Okay, and plus two, the Most High is going to put the spirit upon them, not just the Russians. You got it to where the Iranians are going to be involved in. And the scripture talks about within the book of 2nd Ezra, the 15th chapter, how the Iranians are going to remember their old spirit of being wild warrior spirits. That is the Persians. That was the Persian Empire. They are the descendants of the Persian Empire, man. Okay, they're the descendants of those people. So when they return onto that spirit of being Carmanians, man, being Persians, man, they're going to be like, look, we got to come down on America with the hammer, man. Okay, we're gonna come down on those people with the hammer. So they're gonna return into their old spirit, man. Okay, so let's go back onto here in the book of Isaiah, the 13th chapter. Now go straight to the point on this one. So it says here, in Isaiah, the 13th chapter and the 6th verse, it says, "How ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand, and it shall come as a destruction from the Almighty." Okay, so the day of the Lord is at hand, and it's gonna come as a destruction from the Almighty. That's the rule book. It ain't gonna be like a day of peace, and people gonna be, yay, you know, we're good. Okay, now we can do more wickedness. That's what a lot of people think. They say, look, the Most High doesn't hate you, he hates the sin. Hold on a minute, you're the one that was committing the sin. Doth not the history of the scripture show you that the people that commit those sins was gonna be destroyed? Was it Sodom and Gomorrah held as a place and as a standard not to be? And you got it to where the same thing, the same resurgence of wickedness is happening right now. You got this people doing the same amount of wickedness, just like how when Babylon was destroyed, they're doing the same amount of wickedness. Okay, remember when Babylon we had it to where the nations were confused, okay, and they was dispersed. Okay, you got it to where people now they're trying to amalgamate their philosophies, trying to amalgamate the. And that's where Roman Catholicism comes into play, man. Okay, that's where Roman Catholicism comes into play, because here it is, Roman Catholicism has it to where they amalgamate the ideas of the Greco-Roman Empire. They put that within, we spin it off and call it Christianity. They amalgamate the ideas of the Moabites, add it to Christianity, spin it off, and that's going to be a doctrine.